Formula One returns to Sao Paulo once again with the stage set for what promises to be another classic Brazilian Grand Prix. Sebastian Vettel famously clinched his third championship here in 2012. And in 2016, Max Verstappen treated us to one of the finest wet weather drives of all time. We're racing today then at Interlagos, a historic 2.7-mile circuit and one of the few anti-clockwise tracks on the calendar. 15 corners in total, 9 to the left and 6 to the right, with a technical middle section opening up to a flat-out sector 3. And that gives us our best passing opportunity down into turn 1. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today, it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of turn 1. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
Well, the throttle goes both ways, Crofty. You've got to have the discipline not to try and win the race on the first lap, so always be prepared to lift early and give those around you more space. Trying to be the last of the late breakers with half a dozen cars around you may pay off from time to time, but it's also a great way to lose your front wing.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he starts from pole position. And it's Charles Leclerc in P2. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Norris, Sainz, Valtteri Bottas, and Gasly, Perez, Moore, Ricciardo, and Antonio Giovinazzi, Russell, Ocon, and Guan Yu Zhou, and Matsushita, Tsunoda, Latifi, Lance Stroll, and Nikita Mazepin, Vettel, and Mick Schumacher. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head to trackside for today's race.
fantastic drive, and it means you're driver's world champion. What a result. Enjoy it.
And with that, another year of Formula One draws to a close, and the new World Drivers' Champion is declared. Another entry added to that prestigious list of the sport's most incredible drivers. Another superb Brazilian Grand Prix comes to an end, and it's a thoroughly deserved victory. Anthony, tell me, what was it that helped them achieve this success?
I feel like consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalize on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
And here we are, a team that is no stranger to the podium, taking their place on top once again. A sublime race today, and a stunning win for Ferrari. Advantage at the top has been reduced. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
I have to say Sebastian Vettel certainly caught my eye during today's race. Incredible driving.
And it's another title in the bag for Red Bull. After a long and hard-fought season, they've built an astonishing car this year, and the glory they'll be taking back to Milton Keynes is fully deserved. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.